entered into partnership with me in giving and receiving, except you only. Even in Thessalonica, you sent me help for my needs once and again. Not that I seek the gift, but I seek the fruit that increases to your credit. I have received full payment and more. I am well supplied, having received from Epaphroditus the gifts you sent, a fragrant offering, a sacrifice acceptable and pleasing to God. And my God will supply every need of yours according to his riches in the glory in Christ Jesus. To our God and Father be glory, forever and ever. Amen. O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thanks be to God.
The Holy Gospel according to St. Luke, the 17th chapter. On the way to Jerusalem, Jesus was passing along between Samaria and Galilee, and as he entered a village, he was met by 10 lepers who stood at a distance and lifted up their voices, saying, "Jesus, Master, have mercy on us." When he saw them, he said to them, "Go and show yourself to the priest." And as they went, they were cleansed. Then one of them, when he saw that he was healed, turned back, praising God with a loud voice, and he fell on his face at Jesus' feet, giving him thanks. Now he was a Samaritan. Then Jesus answered, "Were not 10 cleansed? Where are the 9? Was no one found to return and give praise to God except this foreigner?" And he said to him, "Rise and go your way. Your faith has made you well." O Lord, have mercy on us.
Thank you, God.
In many and various ways, God spoke to his people of old by the prophets. We hear again from the text of Deuteronomy 8. suffered under Pontius Pilate, was crucified, died, and was buried. He descended into hell. The third day he rose again from the dead. He ascended into heaven and sits at the right hand of God the Father. God the Son has purchased us from all sins, from death, from the power of the devil. And as we say in the catechism, he has purchased us not with gold or silver, but with his holy, precious blood, and with his innocent suffering and death, for us to be his own, and to live under him in his kingdom. So especially in this time of pandemic, you might say, this time of uncertainty, some of the effects of our sin are painfully clear, as we see the sickness and fear and death that original sin brought upon all creation. In this time of pandemic, then, we can give thanks, and knowing that all things of Jesus, all the things he accomplished at the cross, and the victory he won at the resurrection, all these gifts of life are freely and abundantly given us by the Son. Moses, in bringing the Israelites to the Promised Land, reminded them of the gift of the Word. After talking to them about bread and water and all that they need, it was then about the Word, Deuteronomy 8:3. The Lord gives you to know that man does not live by bread alone, but man lives by every word that comes from the mouth of the Lord. The Word, John tells us, is God the Son, who redeemed the world, including, of course, you and me, our families. And now the gifts of the Word are brought to us by the Holy Spirit. So we give thanks that we are the people of the third article of the Creed. I believe in the Holy Spirit, the Holy Christian Church, the communion of saints, the forgiveness of sins, the resurrection of the body, and the life everlasting. The Holy Spirit is given to us as our advocate, our comforter, our encourager. He brings to us constantly the word of Christ, Jesus crucified. By this gospel, he gathers and continues gathering us into the church. In the church, he's constantly forgiving sins by the cleansing of baptism, by having the cross proclaimed, and by the distribution of the body and blood of Christ to all his people. So we give thanks.